Morning. Thank you for the invitation to talk here. I'm going to talk about Rarita Sphingr Tie Operator on Sphere. It is a joint work, it's an advance, a joint work with Jun Sha Li and John Ryan. I will split my talk in these six parts: Rarita Sphingr Operators on Spheres, conformal invariance of PK under the Kelly transformation and its inverse, the intertwining formulas for RK, it's a Rarita Sphingr operator on Euclidean space, and RKS, a Rarita Sphingr operator on a sphere, and part four, the fundamental solutions of RKS. Part five, Stock theorem, and Borel-Pompeo theorem. It is an extension of the former work, the Chun-Sha Li talk a few minutes ago. Okay, first we can define the Kelly transformation. How is this? To this expression, where x is a point, is a vector in Rn, and En plus 1 is a unit vector in Rn plus 1, and we take Xs in Sn, the unit sphere, and we can define the inverse of the Kelly transformation through this other one expression. We remember the Dirac operator on the sphere is defined by W times lambda plus n over 2, where W is in Sn, and lambda is the operator defined through this sum. Now, in order to define the Rarita Sphingr operator, we take a function, first take a domain U in Rn, and we consider a function F star defined on U times Rn with values in CL plus 1. This is the Clifford algebra generated by E1, En plus 1. Such this function is a left monogenic polynomial homogeneous of degree K in U. This function f star reduced to a function fxu defined on cu. C is the Kelly transformation applied to the domain in Rn times Rn, where in this form fxu is a left monogenic polynomial homogeneous degree K in U. The spherical Dirac operator respect to Xs applied to the function fxu is harmonic in U, and for this reason we can apply the Almansi-Fisher decomposition, where the first term is a left monogenic polynomial homogeneous of degree K, and the second one is a left monogenic polynomial homogeneous of degree K minus 1 also in U. We can also consider a function G star, and this function is a right monogenic polynomial in U, and this function also reduced to this function on CU times Rn. Now we consider the left projection map PK defined on HK. HK is the space of the harmonic polynomial homogeneous of degree K, and this map goes to MK. MK is the space of the monogenic polynomial homogeneous of degree K, and where with this PK we define our Rarita Sphingr type operator in this form. PK apply to this harmonic function, Dirac operator, spherical Dirac operator, respect to S, F. We can also define the right rarita Schwinger operator in this form. And where here PKR means the right projection on HK to MK bar. MK bar means the bright monogenic polynomial of degree K. Therefore, we have left and right spherical rarita Schwinger type equations defined in this form. In order to prove the conformal invariance of PK under C and C minus 1, we need the Hayasawa decomposition of the Kelly transformation and of its inverse. We can rewrite the Kelly transformation in this form, and this is the Hayasawa decomposition for C, and also we can rewrite C minus 1 in this form, and this is also the Hayasawa decomposition for the inverse of the Kelly transformation. Now, we needed the following observation. We have FXU defined on VS time Rn. VA is a domain in Sn. And Mrs. Lee, she showed that PK is conformally invariant under a general Möbius transformation over Rn. And C is a Möbius transformation also. So this trivially extends to a Möbius transformation on Rn plus 1. So it follows that if we restrict S in Sn, then PK is also conformally invariant under the Kelly transformation C and its inverse. And so we have the following two theorems. we see PKW applied to this function, where GC minus 1 is the conformal weight for the inverse of the Kelly transformation and is defined through this expression. And it is equal to GC minus 1 PKU applied to F. And similar, we have the result, but now it's using the Kelly transformation C. So we also see the conformal invariance PKJF is equal G PKF. And now GCX is the conformal weight for the Kelly transformation and is defined through this expression. Now we have in part three the intertwining formula for RK and RKS. And in order to show the intertwining formula for this operator, we will use the intertwining formula for Dirac operator respect to X and spherical Dirac operator respect to S. So we have this theorem, G minus 1 C minus 1 XS times the rarita Schwinger operator respect to U applied to F equal the spherical rarita Schwinger operator applied to J F. And here U is defined in this is equal to this expression, and G minus 1 C minus 1 S is defined through this other. And also, we have a similar results when we use the Kelly transformation. Former, we use the before we use C minus 1. Now we use C. Okay. And if we see these both theorem, in this theorem. If RKUF is zero, so we have this is zero, and also here, if K, U, F is 0. This is 0, so we have this corollary. Lk u f equals 0 if and only if these two equalities are 0. Now we recall the reproducing kernel of this space. This space is a space of a spherical, it's a monogenic polynomials, homogeneous of degree K. And it's defined through this summation. This summation is taking over all permutation of the monomials without repetition. And this function is left monogenic in U and is also right monogenic in V. And it is homogeneous of degree K in both U and V. We construct our fundamental solution for this operator with the help of the kernel of the Rarita Schwinger operator in Euclidean space. So we take this fundamental solution for this operator, and we rewrite this function in this form. Okay? Ck is a constant defined through this expression, and we observe that it's a vector in Rn. If we apply the Kelly transformation to this former kernel, we obtain up to a constant Ck through, over omega n this expression, and this expression is our fundamental solution to this equation, okay? In order to show the Stowe theorem, we need this product. This product is defined through this integral over Sn minus 1, and we observe that any pk, any polynomial, monogenic polynomial, can be obtained through this inner product with respect to V of set K and PK of V. So we have our Stowe theorems. Suppose US is a domain on Sn, and S is a sufficiently smooth hypersurface in US, bounding a subdomain Vs of US. Then we have our Stowe theorem, and here we consider our functions f and g continuously differentiable and defined on us times rn, and they have values in mk. As remarked, we proved that the Stowe theorems for Rarita Schwinger operators, spherical Rarita operators, conformally invariant under the Kelly transformation. And if we take here, equal 0 and equal 0, we have our Cauchy theorem as a corollary. We have our Cauchy theorems. And using our fundamental solution, we can prove, we can use this to prove the Borel-Pompeo theorem, an important theorem. And here we suppose US, VS, and LS like in Stowe theorem. And we have YS in VS, and our function F is defined in this space. And we observe here that if we change this function through a test function, this part is 0, and we have a new result. And if we consider this equal 0, we have our Cauchy integral formula. You can see that here, as I said, look at this. And that is all. We use for the, this work the following reference. This is the work, the recent work of Lee, Ryan, and Duncan, Peter Van Lanke, and these are other references. Thank you.